anybody just needs to pick up the newspaper to realize that diabetes is at monumental epidemic proportions. There's a real opportunity to change how type 2 is being treated. So research is hugely important. I was diagnosed with type 2 diabetes probably about a year ago. The scariest moment I had was I was experiencing a low. So it means basically your blood sugar is very, very low. So that is either caused by lack of food or too much exercise or a combination of both. So it starts to plunge, you feel dizzy, you begin to sweat, you just feel very confused. It was a Saturday morning, I'd sort of had a quick breakfast and then gone to the Y, and I think what I had done, it was around lunchtime, I hadn't had enough to eat, I've exercised maybe a little bit more than I should have, and I was just doing some grocery shopping and running around, so I pulled into the parking lot of the store I was at, and it hit me pretty quickly. So what was scary about that was the fact that I could have just as easily been driving on the highway or driving on a busy road. The theory behind reset is that it gives your pancreas, which produces insulin, a rest. So first 3 weeks of the program, I take insulin, and they train you how to do that, how to do the needles, when to do it, how much. I'm off the metformin, and it basically kind of gives your pancreas a rest for 3 weeks. Then you go back to your regular medication of metformin, and then in 3 months' time, you have another 2 weeks of insulin that again gives the pancreas a rest. Ultimately, not that diabetes is going to make me healthier, but ultimately, it's changed my choices, my food choices, my life choices, and you know, really, I was already halfway there, but it has significantly changed that in a way I didn't really expect.